Well, with me now is Anne Graham Lotz. It's wonderful to have you here with us.
Thank you, Carrie. So glad to be with you. Thank you for having me.
It's great. You just finished your book, Jesus in Me. Well, it's just newly out and such a pretty cover. I mean, you can't miss it in the bookstore, right? But the message that you bring is such a needed one today. I think people are excited to see you here in person and doing well because you've been through a long journey health-wise. How are you today?
I'm doing so well. And you know, they don't have markers for this kind of cancer. And so I think if I survive 5 years and they just feel like I've got it behind me, but I'm doing well. I haven't gotten quite all my strength and energy back, but actually that may be age too, Terry.
Yeah. Never get yeah, it back. I can vouch for that.
Yeah.
You had three losses in pretty close proximity, starting with your husband, Danny. And though he was ill and you had been his caregiver for 3 years, you weren't expecting him to die that day.
No.
Tell me about that day and how the Holy Spirit met you at that place of loss.
Well, I had, he was out by the pool. He loved our pool. And he was sitting there playing with a dog. And I'd gone inside the house and I was just getting some work done. And you know how it goes. I lost my focus. I lost an awareness of time. And then I realized it had been an hour since I checked on him. And I went and checked on him and found him unresponsive in the pool. So I called EMS. We took him to the hospital, kept him on life support for 2 days. And then when we released him, he went to heaven. And, but the Holy Spirit was there from the moment, you know, he was taken to the hospital through family, friends, the doctors, people who, I didn't really open it up for people to come by because it, and just what he wasn't himself. But anyway, and then when he went to heaven, the Holy Spirit stepped in and just gave me wisdom for planning a service, doing all the practical arrangements you have to make. It was just amazing and blessed me and blessed me so that although I grieved and mourned, I never went into that pit.
Yes. You know? So. But when all of that is over, when you've kind of recognized that he's gone and he's not coming back, when you've gone through the arrangements for the service and the funeral is over, and you come back home, I mean, the reality, especially when you've been a caregiver, it's like there's a hole in your world. How did you contend with that?
It was very hard to let him go because I still felt like he needed to be cared for. Very hard to leave the cemetery, to tell you the truth. But the Lord was so gracious, and he had my daughter and her husband. They were homeless at the time. They moved in with me. So for the first 16 months, I never spent a night by myself in the, in the home. So then they moved out, and the Lord was right there to take me up. But I'll tell you something, Terry, because when my husband left, then I became a widow. And 3 years later, Daddy left, and I became an orphan. And loneliness knocked at my door, you know, because and especially when I was diagnosed with cancer. And it's like I wanted to talk to my husband. What surgeon do I go to, and what treatment do I choose? Mm-hmm. And I wanted to go to Daddy and say, Daddy, set me up with your doctors at Mayo's, or, you know, and I didn't have anybody to go to, but I had the Holy Spirit.
And he really guided you through that.
He did.
I mean, you were actually going in one direction, and the Spirit came in and halted you.
That's right.
But part of that, Anne, was because you were so tuned in to his voice. I mean, throughout the book, you show where there was just a warning, a sense of God changing your direction. How do you stay in touch like that?
I think you maintain your relationship with God through faith in Jesus. I had to establish that relationship, Terry, when I was a little girl. I invited Jesus to come into my heart after I'd repented of my sin. And I didn't know about the Holy Spirit. In church, he was called the Holy Ghost, you know. So I invited Jesus in my heart, but Jesus understood, and he came into me in the person of the Holy Spirit. And then I've developed that relationship, just like a marriage relationship where you spend time with your spouse and you talk to him, he talks to you, you listen, you know, go through problems and stress, and you get to know each other. And so the Holy Spirit, he talks to me through God's Word. In fact, the back of the book, I have a section on how to hear his whispers, because he just whispers through his Word, you know, and you take his Word, you apply it, you live it out, and you find that was the Holy Spirit speaking to you. Mm-hmm. I talk to him through prayer, and he really is Jesus in me. So the Holy Spirit is a distinct person, but he's the invisible Jesus. And when I was telling you about the loneliness, I dedicated the book to the lonely, and that was before I came across the statistic that 22% of Americans, adult Americans, are so desperately lonely, they have suicidal thoughts.
Wow.
And that it's an epidemic among millennials, because I think millennials live in a virtual world and maybe they lack face-to-face relationships.
Out of touch with people generally.
And the Holy Spirit is God's antidote to loneliness. You know, the Holy Spirit just fills that void. And when you learn to hear his whispers and you talk to him, he guides, he instructs, he gives wisdom, strength, help, and he loves me. You know, the Holy Spirit's committed to me.
What do you think are the most common maybe inaccuracies that we think of or hang on to about the Holy Spirit?
Well, I think a lot of mainline church people think of him, they don't think of him. He's in baptisms,
he's
weddings.
It.
Oh, yeah, he's it. And it's like, God bless you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, or the Holy Ghost. You know, he's like a P.S., like a tag on. And I think in other circles, he's like a flame of fire. He's a dove. He's an ecstatic experience. He's emotion. He's, and the Holy Spirit actually is none of those things. He is the third person of the Godhead, not because he's the least, but because God the Father is primarily revealed in the Old Testament, then God the Son in the Gospels, and God the Holy Spirit in the Acts and the Epistles. So he's the third to be more fully revealed, but he's not the least.
Yes.
You know, he's not an add-on. He's not an optional extra in the Christian life. And I think a lot of church people and people like I was, we treat him like an optional extra, and he's a divine necessity. You cannot live your Christian life. You cannot go through deaths and disease and divorce and some of the things. I've not been through divorce, but other, you know, difficulties
just
and disasters.
The traumas of life.
Yes, you can't go through it. You can survive, but you can't go through it triumphantly without the Holy Spirit. And I will tell you, I have never lost my joy or my peace or the awareness of God's blessing. God has poured out his blessings on me. And I know that's the evidence of the Holy Spirit within.
Well, the things that you went through and in such short, or it was like in a 3-year time frame, I think that you lost these three very important people and then situations in your life leave you with almost like a post-traumatic stress condition if you don't have the Holy Spirit to lean on. What do you say to people who today find themselves in that situation?
Turn to Jesus. You know, and if you haven't established a relationship, establish one and then start to develop it. And I would encourage you, sorry, but to get the book because I make it so plain and
you do.
Use personal examples. This is not a doctrinal statement on the Holy Spirit. It's not a full treatment of all his ins and outs and the controversies. It's my experience of the Holy Spirit as a constant companion.
Mm-hmm.
And I've laid it out so that I pray that when people read it, that they would want him to be their constant companion also.
Yes.
And it's so obvious in there how you can do that, that it would walk them through that. So don't just turn to Jesus. You may not know his name is the Holy Spirit in you, but you just turn to Jesus and he will turn to you, the Bible says.
Well, as one who read it, I want to say too, you need to get the book. It is called Jesus in Me, Experiencing the Holy Spirit as a Constant Companion. It's possible, and this book is very clear on how that can be a possibility in your life. It's available wherever books are sold. Thank you for being here and for another wonderful message that helps us put our roots down deeper.
Yeah.
Great
Thank
to
you.
Have
God
you
God bless you.
You
Thanks.
Too. Wonderful to see you looking so well.
Thanks.